Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's your brother Yahya Ibrahim with another daily tafsir. Alhamdulillah, we're in juz number 18 of a juz a day. Juz number 18 begins with Surah Al-Mu'minun. And Surah Al-Mu'minun is a surah that is dearly beloved to the believers. It's the description is about belief and unbelief, and Allah speaking about the consequences and the rewards for either side. The surah begins with Allah listing certain characteristics that the believers have. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ Successful are the believers. الَّذِينَ هُمْ They are those who. And then Allah mentions certain traits. في صلاتهم خاشعون. The first of them is that they have humility and khushu'ah, an awareness and awe and supremacy of Allah in their prayers. They abstain from vain talk. They are giving of their alms and zakah. They are guarding of their private relationships and of a careful not to fall into sexual misconduct. They are those who are watchful of their trust and the covenants that they exchange with others. They fulfill their covenant. And they are those who once again لِصَلَاتِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ They guard their prayers. So in the beginning, Allah begins with prayer, that a person has humility, and in the end, Allah says that they're guarding of it. They're very careful with it, that it's done on time, in the right way, and in the right capacity, as best as they can. It's a powerful, powerful beginning to that chapter. Then Allah transitions to speak about the signs of disbelievers. And Allah does this by speaking about the story of Nuh alayhi salam and other nations that were destroyed by Allah. And Allah speaks about the people of Nuh as being a rebellious people who had arrogance and who were unwilling to conform to what easily could be recognizable as a statement that calls them to purity and a path to faith and truth. So Allah speaks about this by speaking about the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon them and them not being worthy of it because of their rejection of it, and that other generations who followed continued in that disbelief except the few who came to believe. And Allah wants us to be from those who are believers, who have certain signs, and Allah shares more signs. There are those who have a magnificence and an awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have a firmness of faith. And they are those who do not make shirk, who don't want to join anything in worship with Allah, knowing that everything that is of value spiritually is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they give their fear only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are cognizant of their relationship with their maker and creator, and how they live with other people impacts that relationship with the Almighty. The disbelievers, on the other hand, are given two primary characteristics, that they are those who are arrogant and proud, and they are unwilling to accept truth that is clear truth, and unwilling to come to a path, even to a compromise of what they know is right and what they know is good, because it has come from a particular messenger. Whenever the messengers would come to them, they would reject faith on account of their arrogance and pride. The second characteristic is that they're wasteful of time until the moment comes of regret. And they don't take care of the amount of years that Allah has blessed us with, the wealth we've been blessed with, the health we've been blessed with in the life that we live. And then Allah speaks about them returning on the Day of Judgment. قَالُوا رَبَّنَا ارْجِعْنَا نَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا O Allah, return us to the life that we will do righteous deeds. Give us another chance. We missed out this time. Allow us one more opportunity. كَلَّا إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ هُوَ قَائِلُهَا Allah says, no, rather it is just a word that you say. In another place, وَلَوْ رُدُّوا لَعَادُوا لِمَا نُهُوا عَنْهُ If they were to be returned, they would do exactly the same and make the same bad choices. So Allah then speaks about consequences, that the trumpet, that the heralding of the Day of Judgment will be blown, and everyone will know the matter has been decided, and deeds will be weighed, and people will then begin to have conversations about the regrets that they had, and the people of Jannah will be proud, and the people of Hellfire will be worried. May Allah make us from Ashabul Yameen, Allahumma Ameen. The disbelievers, therefore, can never find success. And therefore, success and belief are used interchangeably in the surah, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْفَالِحُونَ Mu'minun are those who are successful, because successful are the believers. They are those who at the end of the day do one particular thing, which is the most pleasing to Allah, after Tawheed, which is to ask him for his forgiveness. This leads us into the next chapter. which is part of Juz number 18, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to us in Surah number 25, Surah An-Nur, the light, which is referenced into the verse of light, which is halfway through the surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Surah An-Nur, that is a surah that speaks about social conventions and what is moral and what is immoral, especially as it relates to sexuality and sexual misconduct. It also speaks about the importance of guarding the tongue and how we use it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has verses about chastity and honoring each other's relationships. The worst of evil is fornication, from the act that a human being can do of allowing his base desire to take over their mission in life. And there are punishments and consequences that are listed in the first page of the surah. Accusations against chaste women are as severe as committing sexual acts of misconduct. Rulings of li'an are established. If someone suspects their spouse of having committed adultery, what are the ways of taking an oath to this? The incident of Aisha, hadithatul ifq, which is outlined in the second page of this surah, and is prominently featured in the sunnah, in the Sahih of Bukhari and Muslim, is directly spoken about in this surah, and her innocence is declared by Allah from above the seven heavens. The etiquettes of modesty are outlined in the surah. Don't enter someone's house without permission. Don't look into people's place without permission. Keep your gaze lowered from that which is enticing and that which you don't have right to see. Do not display openly your beauty in a way of vulgarity to attract attention from others. Unmarried people should be try to get married as soon as they're able, and people should try to assist them in getting married. Do not compel those who are captive into immodest dealings, and don't marry people who practice prostitution as a living, seeking the pleasures of this worldly life by making money out of it. All of those are verses that are mentioned in the surah. Then Allah speaks about the guidance of Allah, and the imagery of the light of Allah is used as the source of guidance. Allahu nuru samawati wal ard, mathalu nurihi kamishkatin fiha misbah. God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, is the light of the heavens and the earth. Subhanallah. It's a beautiful, beautiful verse. It's one of the most commented on in verses, and I recommend for you to listen to the tafsir of it by my dear brother and colleague, Dr. Yasir Qadi. He's got a wonderful statement and YouTube videos on it, inshallah. Believers are those who benefit from the light of Allah, and Allah gives the parable of the unbelievers as having one of two things. Either they see a mirage, they see something that they think is right, when they get to it, حتى إذا جاءه لم يجده شيئا, when they arrive to it, it's just a mirage, it's nothing. Or they're in the other state, which is just complete darkness. ظُلُمَاتٌ بَعْضُهَا فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ, darkness above darkness. If they were to put their hand in front of their face, لَمْ يَكَدْ يَرَاهَا, they can't even see it. The third section of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the signs of belief, that everything claims belief in Allah, proclaims the purity of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some will turn back from their sinfulness and come back to Allah, and repentance is always open for a believer who has come and defiled themselves in the sight of Allah. Those who truly believe are those who give their zakah, and that's one of the first things that is mentioned, and establish their salah and have righteous actions, in particular with their society and those who they live with. Allah then speaks about the needs and the seeking to protect children and those who are in bondage. And Allah speaks about the rules for the elderly. And Allah speaks about the call of the Prophet ﷺ is to call people to that light of Allah and call them to that which will enrich them in life. The closing of the juz begins Surah Al-Furqan, which is the 25th chapter of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Surah Al-Furqan, which means the criterion, the divider between right and wrong, good and bad, halal and haram, but also tawheed and shirk, and a good action from bad action. Allah speaks about it by speaking about the importance of praising the Almighty, identifying Him before the day of judgment, where the Furqan will be made for us as well, where we will be divided into two groups, the believers and the unbelievers. It's the very first initial openings of Surah Al-Furqan that is found at the last pages of this juz number 18. I pray that you will join me, inshallah, for another juz a day in our daily tafsir. with your brother Yahya Ibrahim. This was juz number 18. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.